Hi, this is Victor, the Director of Content with BlueDAG. Today we're going to go over how to conduct an evaluation using the mobile application. First thing we want to do is find our evaluation and set the status to conducting. Once we do that, we click Save, and then we can jump over to our mobile app. Now on the mobile device, we'll locate the BlueDAG app and tap on the icon. Once it opens up, we'll input our login credentials, and then we'll get the evaluation screen. The first thing you want to do is hit the sync button at the top right-hand corner. That way, it'll make sure that your application has the most current information from the BlueDAG portal. Next, tap on the evaluation name that we want to work in. Now, if you wanted, you could have added area descriptions in the portal before the sync, and those would come down to the mobile application. If you need to add a new area description, what we'll do here is go ahead and tap on the pencil at the top right-hand corner, and then the Edit Area Description screen will appear. Click the plus button at the top right, and then type in our new area description. Once that's done, we'll hit save and tap back on the top left-hand corner of the screen. Before we add a finding, let's look at the bottom of the screen and we can see three icons: findings, checklist, and details. If you tap on the details icon, it'll take you to the details page of the evaluation. Here, we can add a cover photo for the evaluation report. Tap on the camera icon on the top right-hand corner of the screen. The application will access your camera. Once you take a photo, the application will give you a choice to either retake the photo or keep the one you took. Now that we have a cover photo, let's go back and add a finding. Let's tap on the findings icon at the bottom of the screen, and then we'll click the plus button next to the area description where we want to add the finding. Once we're there, we'll get a new blank finding page. We can tap on the camera icon at the top right-hand corner of the screen and follow the same process as we did before to take the cover photo. Please note that you can repeat the photo-taking process as many times as you want. After you take your photos, you can tap on the thumbnail at the top of the screen and it'll open up the camera album. Then you can tap on those thumbnails and open up the full-size version of the photo for your review. Once you're done, you tap back on the top left-hand corner of the screen and it'll take you back to the finding page. Under the area description, there is a button to geolocate if you want to add coordinates to the specific finding. Here, our groups are listed in alphabetical order. Just scroll up or down on the screen until you find the group that you need. Once you select the group, you'll go back to the main finding page. Now you can select the next option in the drop-down menu. You may have the option to add a type, subtype, subtype 2, and subtype 3. But please keep in mind that not all findings go all the way to subtype 3. Once all the types and subtypes are selected, you'll go down and fill out the as-built condition. Here you can put in the measurement or any note that you need. Next, you can scroll down and review the finding text or even add a recommendation. Adjust the budget, set a priority, or include some notes. You can even go down and change the status from open, corrected, to compliant. Next, you can tap on the figure if one is provided and see a blown up version of it for further details. Once you're done with that, you can click Save, Save a New, or click the up arrow to duplicate the same issue. I'll go ahead and click Save a New, and you can see I'll get a brand new finding sheet to fill out. Now I can just resume the process, take my photo, select my drop-down options, include my new as-built condition, and hit save. If I just tap on save, it'll take me back to the area description page where I can select a different area description to add findings to. Tap the checklist icon at the bottom of the screen, and then the checklist page will load. Again, all our checklists here are listed in alphabetical order. If you don't see the checklist that you need, try tapping on the word all. This may reveal other checklists that you might use in your evaluation. If you notice, some checklists have a gray icon and a blue icon. If you select the checklist with the blue icon, those are what we consider parent checklists. What that means is once you complete that checklist, the application will give you suggestions to complete other checklists that are usually associated to that element. To open a checklist, tap the plus button to the right of the checklist name. This will take you to the checklist screen. Next, you'll add an area description, geolocate if you need to, and then tap next at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. Once you do that, the first question of the checklist will appear. To read the question, pick your answer, and a check mark will appear next to the answer you've selected. Click Next at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, and the next question will load. If you tap the eye icon next to the question, it'll load additional guidance if one is available. Select your answer for your question, and hit Next again. And just repeat the process until you've gone through all the questions in the checklist. Now, if you select an answer that will trigger a finding, the mobile application will give a prompt to take a photo. Click Yes on your prompt and take as many photos as you need to document the issue. As before, you can add notes to your as-built condition, click Next, and at the end of the checklist, click Save. Now you can see here that you can get suggestions for other checklists since we started at a parent checklist. Here we can just tap the plus button next to the checklist we want to complete and just continue and repeat the process. Next, we can show one last feature on the Findings tab. Tap on the Findings icon there at the bottom left-hand corner of your screen. Then the plus button next to an area description to add a finding. Then we'll scroll to right above the bare finder bar. You'll see the word search. Tap on that. The search screen will appear. Once it does, you can click on the search field and type in a term. And what the application will do, it will search for that term through all the findings that are associated to the bare standards of the evaluation. Once you find the one you like, tap on it, and the application will automatically fill out the drop-down menus for you. Then all you'll have to do is add the as-built conditions, notes, recommendations, or any other fields that you choose. And then just hit save, and we're done. When you're done with your evaluation, tap back on the top left-hand corner of the screen to get to the main evaluation page. At the top right-hand corner, tap on the sync button. This will send all your information from your mobile device to the BlueDAG portal. Once the sync is done, you can go back to the portal, review your evaluation, go under the Findings tab, and review your findings. Thanks for watching.